But Honorable Speaker, today this institution, which is the people-centered parliament, has not come out comprehensively, unequivocally, to explain itself to the people, for which we are saying people-centered parliament, to account.
I agreed as this House that we should have evidence-based debates.
Addressing the press today at Parliament, the Leader of Opposition, Joel Senyonyi, lashed out at the Speaker and demanded that she addresses accountability queries which the public is putting against Parliament regarding the alleged extravagance and misappropriation of public funds rather than going on a fishing expedition.
The Speaker has also been on the loose, blaming everybody she can blame. She has blamed homosexuals. I saw her blaming the Right Honourable Rebecca Kadaga, saying these old women who are fighting us, we don't know what they left in the Speaker's office and they want to reclaim. And she said, you see, they're developing their areas. Kamuli is developed. Why don't they want us to develop our other areas? It is clear who she was talking about. She was talking about the Right Honorable Rebecca Kadaga. I don't know if there are any personal issues between those two leaders. That's none of my business. My business is that the Speaker accounts for taxpayers' money.
He also slammed those who think that demanding for accountability from Speaker Among is disrespectful. Senyonyi noted that they will not bow to this kind of blackmail until the abused funds are returned to government coffers.
We have seen the Speaker of Parliament coming out to say she has got the support of Mr. Museveni, as if to say that all of you Ugandans who are asking her for answers, you can go to hell. We want to remind the Speaker of Parliament, who we respect because of the office she occupies, and that's not in doubt. We're not asking these questions out of disrespect, as some people are saying. How can the Speaker be disrespected? Well, the Speaker occupies a public office. The money we are talking about is public money. So it's our job to ask for accountability for public money.
The Leader of Opposition also revealed that following the failure by Parliament to comprehensively respond to the issues raised in public, he has since written to the Director of Public Prosecution, Francis Alobo, Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamya, and Auditor General, John Mwanga, to conduct an investigation into allegations of corruption and abuse of office at Parliament.
Talked about the letters that I have written to the different entities. The first one is to the Inspectorate of Government, and this letter was received. I am asking and urging the Inspector General of Government to investigate the financial impropriety, all these allegations, financial impropriety, irregular staff recruitment, this contract of the radio station, and so on and so forth, happening here at Parliament.
Senyonyi has also addressed queries surrounding the PADM he received on his trip to Nairobi when he visited the ailing Muhammad Segirinya, the Kawempe South Member of Parliament, saying that he was shocked to receive PADM payment for 5 days, yet he had clearly indicated to the technical team at Parliament that his trip was only for a day and all the excess pay was returned back to Parliament.
Billions of shillings on two people's accounts, and then they are withdrawn immediately. What exactly is this money doing? Going on to people's individual accounts.
Senyonyi also reacted to recent reports that some of the people behind exposing the corruption are being threatened with arrest and kidnap, describing such ploys as cowardly, saying the opposition will relent on demanding for accountability of all the issues raised.
Threats. We have been seeing whistleblowers and other people, members of the public, who are raising these concerns, and we understand their threats to their lives. I want to urge, whether it be the Speaker and other leaders against whom concerns are being raised, let's not be cowards.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.